Okay, so how do we minimize the power required to maintain steady flight with airspeed? That's what we want to do today. So we're going to minimize power required. Of course, power, just like thrust, is something that costs, right? In order to operate our power plant, our engine, we've got to use fuel. And energy, right? So it's going to cost us something. So we want to minimize it. We want to fly at an airspeed or at a condition that minimizes the power required. Okay? So recall first that the power required can be written a couple different ways. So I'm going to first write it in a way that's not fully simplified, okay? Because it's going to be a little bit easier to work with. So the power required looks something like this. CD naught, so root 2 times CD naught divided by CL to the 3 halves plus CD naught L divided by CL to the 1 half plus CL to the 1 half divided by pi ERA times W square root W over SW divided by rho. Okay, so you might have seen this also written in a different form that's a little bit more simplified that looks like this. CD naught rho v cubed divided by 2 times w over sw plus CD naught L times v plus 2w over s divided by pi e ra rho v all times w. Okay, these are the same thing. Okay, the bottom one is just a simplified version of the top one. We're going to stick with the top one today because it's a little bit easier to work with. Okay, so we're going to start off actually by finding the lift coefficient at which the power required is minimized. Okay, so let's change colors here for a minute. So we're going to say find CL where power required is minimized. All right, so of course this is a familiar process by now, hopefully. What we're going to do is we're going to take the power required, the derivative of the power required with respect to CL, and set it equal to zero. Okay, so let's look at this derivative. So it's square root 2 times negative 3 halves CD naught over CL to the 5 halves minus 1 half CD naught L divided by CL to the 3 halves plus 1 half divided by 1 divided by pi E RA CL to the 1 to the 1 half, yes, all on the denominator, times W root W over SW divided by rho. That all equals zero. Okay, so immediately we can cancel off these outside terms, and we're left with negative 3 halves CD naught over CL to the 5 halves minus 1 half CD naught L divided by CL to the 3 halves plus 1 half 1 divided by pi E RA CL to the 1 half. And that all equals 0. Now, if we multiply through by CL to the 1 half, we can get rid of that term. This becomes 1 half. This becomes 3 halves. Okay? And then at the same time, we're going to divide by 1 half. Okay? So we're just going to get bloop, bloop, pull those out. and pull that guy out, and we end up with we're gonna do one more thing too. Okay, so there's three things. One, we're gonna multiply through by CL to the 1/2. We're gonna divide by 1/2. Well, what we'll do is divide by negative 1/2, right? So we get rid of these negatives, and this becomes a negative, right? So the end result here is 3CD naught divided by CL to the 1/2 plus CD naught L. This is 3/2. This is CL to the 1/2. And then minus 1 over pi E R A. Okay, so now we can multiply through by CL squared. Oh, let's see. This is 2/2. This is to the 2/2. Pardon me, I made an error here. So when we multiplied through by CL to the 1/2, this became CL with no exponent here, and this became CL squared. All right? That makes it a whole lot easier. So that equals 0. So now what we can do is we can multiply this entire thing through by CL squared. So we're going to multiply this entire thing through by CL squared and then bring this last term over to the other side. And what we're left with is 3CD naught plus CD naught L times CL equals CL squared divided by pi E R A. Great. Okay, so from here... Now, it's kind of funny that we did this because we're going to bring it all back over. From here, we can write this whole thing out as a polynomial in CL. And then we can solve for the roots. So what we're going to do is we're going to say this entire thing can be rearranged to give us CL squared. So first we're going to multiply through by pi ERA. Then we're going to bring everything over to this other side. Okay. So CL, what that gives us in the end is CL squared minus CD naught L. CL pi E R A minus 3 pi E R A CD naught equals 0. Okay, so now what we want to do is find the roots of this equation. So remember, if we use it's the classic, you know, opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, where a is 1, b is going to be negative cd naught l pi era, and then c is going to be negative 3 pi era cd naught, okay? Quadratic equation. That was the word I was looking for. So let's use the quadratic equation, and what we get with is what we get is pi e r a c d naught l plus or minus the square root of pi e r a c d naught l b squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 3, so this is going to become a plus. Our 4, I'm just going to do some math here real quick. Our 4 becomes a 12, right, because we're multiplying it by 3. So 12 pi E R A C D naught, all divided by 2A, which is 1, all right, 2, right? And this is a CL, correct, right? Okay, so if we pull this out, and I believe we're going to use the plus of the plus or minus, because that's the only one that falls in a typical range for CL, we're going to end up with CL equals pi ERA over 2 times CD naught L plus root CD naught L squared plus 12 CD naught over pi ERA. Okay, so I encourage you to go through this if it's not clear how we got from this point to this point. It's just some algebra. We did some distribution here and multiplied through by pi ERA and such. Okay. All right. So here's our lift coefficient. Again, this is our lift coefficient that minimizes the power required. So great. This is great. All right. Now, it's actually pretty straightforward to go from this now to the velocity. Okay, so let's I'm going to change colors here because now we're going to find the velocity. So find V at which I guess its power required is minimized. And the way we do that is we find the V for which our CL equals this, right? So let's go back to our lift coefficient. So the lift coefficient, recall, we'll do it this way. So let me scroll back up for a second. Oh, just kidding. All right. So I'll just write it all out again. I apologize for that little mistake there. Okay. So our lift coefficient, of course, is weight divided by 1/2 rho V squared SW. If we rearrange that, we can find that the velocity is 2W over SW divided by rho CL. Okay, now all we have to do is plug in our CL and simplify. So let me write that. Plug in, we're going to call this equation star. We're going to plug in star and simplify. Pardon my blotch there. There we go. And what we get is the velocity equals, okay, now I'm going to do my best to write this. It's kind of a crazy long equation. So let me draw a big long fraction here. And also another line here. Sorry, I'm kind of having to be a little bit tricky with my lines, okay? So in the numerator, we have 2. That's easy enough. This line here is actually part of a square root. Okay, so square root of pi e, the alpha pi, sorry, pi e r a c d naught l plus. And now here we have another square root, so I'm going to try and freehand this line. Oh, pi e r a c d naught l squared plus 12 pi e r a c d naught. So you'll recognize this, of course, from our quadratic equation here. Okay, so that's under a square root, which is under a square root, which is in the denominator. And that's all times W over SW over rho. And there you have it. So this is the velocity at which power required is minimized. And this velocity, as you might imagine, is called the minimum power velocity. But the way that we denote it is VmdV, okay? Remember that dV is power. And so this is the minimum power required airspeed, okay? Now, remember, this airspeed is only was derived under the assumption that the thrust angle is small. Okay, and we will not cover what happens if the thrust angle is not small, but you, if you wanted, you could figure this airspeed out for not small thrust angle following the same procedure. It'll just be a little bit more hairy. Okay, now there's something else though, that there's one more assumption that we sometimes make, and to explain it here, I'm going to just draw a quick little plot. So if you'll recall, the drag coefficient, something that we use all the time, right, is very nearly parabolic with respect to the lift coefficient. Oh dear. There we go. Okay, so if we have on the x-axis CL, on the y-axis we have CD, our equation, wow, I apologize guys. Our equation looks something like this usually. Okay, so we have something like that. Okay, sorry, that's a kind of an ugly parabola, but you get the idea. The point is the minimum here falls generally off of this y-axis. What this means is that the point of minimum drag usually occurs at non-zero lift. Okay, now in terms of the equation, remember we have CD naught plus CD naught L times CL plus CL squared over pi E R A. So this first coefficient here, CD naught, generally dictates the vertical position of our minimum. Okay, but this middle term here, CD naught L, is what dictates the horizontal position. So as you change CD naught L, your minimum point goes something like this, right? It moves. And where CD naught L is zero is where this minimum falls, right here on the y-axis. Okay. Now, typically, this distance for most aircraft is small, meaning that CD naught L is small. Okay, so a approximation that you'll see a lot of places is that CD naught L is approximately zero. Okay, now we try not to make that assumption in this course here, and if we ever do, we'll try to be very explicit about it. Okay, because for the vast majority of aircraft, this is not zero. It's really not. Though it is small, it is not zero. Okay, and in some cases, it is significant, but for the cases where it is small, we can make an approximation that simplifies this equation for the minimum drag or minimum power airspeed. Okay, so under this assumption, we can rewrite the let me rephrase that. Making this assumption, we can find the minimum power required using this airspeed. Okay, I hope that makes sense. I misspoke earlier. Okay. So if we make this assumption and plug the minimum power airspeed back into our expression for the power required, we come out with, I apologize again, I smudged. We come out with this. So PR min equals approximately, I'm going to make that very clear. So this approximation is here. We come out with 4 root 2. Times CD naught to the 1/4 divided by 3 pi ERA to the 3/4 power times W root W over SW over rho. Okay, so there's our minimum power required. Again, just to be painfully clear, this is making an assumption that CD naught L is approximately zero and the thrust angle is approximately zero. Okay?